Hi, this is Sean Overton again with OneStepRemove.com. Welcome back. In this video, we're going to discuss the 50-50 coin toss game that I alluded to in the previous video. Here, I've set the winning percentage of our system to exactly 50% with a payout of 1-to-1. If we, and I said, based on our risk of 1% on $100,000, 1% of 100,000 is 1,000. So if we win, we're going to make $1,000, and if we lose, we're going to lose $1,000. We're not going to do anything complicated in this game. There's not going to be fixed fractional money management. There's not going to be any kind of position sizing strategy. We're strictly looking at the dollar risk and watching how it fluctuates over 200 trades. Having placed 200 trades and clicking the calculate button, this is the graph that pops out. So you'll notice that the average comes out almost exactly at $100,000. It's what you expect with a 50-50 game and a 1-to-1 payout. Now the interesting thing is watching the standard deviation and how it changes. Standard deviation is a scary math term, but really what it's telling you is, with some degree of confidence, this is the range of outcomes that I would expect in terms of its distance from the average. So I expect to either make 14 grand or lose 14 grand. That's the simple layman way to think of it. Now here on the extremes, it's going to give me an idea of what's my best case scenario and what's my worst case scenario. In my worst case scenario, risking 1% of the account on a coin toss game, purely random luck, you might lose almost half the account balance over 200 trades. It's very unlikely. If we do the little mouse over here, you can see the percent chance of that happening is 0.54%. Could happen. And then here on the fat tail, we have a return of $58,000. Our account balance finishes at $158,000. That has an even less likely chance of happening of 0.1%. And here in the center is what's going to tell us the most accurate information, where we can see that most of these bars cover the majority of the outcomes. And you see here that the average is almost 100,000, and roughly 50% are below and roughly 50% are above. The thing I like to watch is how changing the losing trade percentage can narrow and widen these bands. So if you are very conservative like myself, it's a little boring, but if you're only risking 0.25% per trade and you're trading 200 times, regardless of how frequent that is, whether it's day trading or over the course of the year, this is the range of expectations you might expect to find. You'll notice the standard deviation dropped from 14,500 down to 3,600. That's a lot more acceptable for me if I'm trading actively. If I'm trading less actively, that's probably a pretty boring return. Nobody's excited about making 3.5%. And you'll notice that the minimum and maximum outcomes, they also dropped dramatically. They dropped to about roughly $12,000 to $14,000 on both ends. Now, if you're a cowboy and you want to go crazy with the risk, you could risk 2% of your account, but look what happens. This is the coin toss game, and if you have the worst luck in the world, you might actually blow up the account. You wind up with $8,000. That's a pretty terrible result. Now, on the same, or in the same vein, you could wind up with over 100% return, not compounded, nothing, just flipping a coin and making or winning $1,000. You can have that kind of variability just from risking 2%. So you might play with this software and get a sense for what sort of risk percentage is something that's comfortable for you, where you're looking at this number, but then you have that feeling deep in your stomach of, well, what? How would I feel if I wound up with this number? You compare those and you find what works for you. And in the next video, we're going to discuss fixed fractional position sizing and how you can use that to put the favorable returns even more strongly in your favor. My name is Sean Overton. Thank you for listening.